This is Charade, former DUI Women's Champion, the only woman in Brutal Impact, Monkey House Studio Film Star, and LI's newest ring rat. My fans have been asking me for the last few days, why Charade? Why? Well, it's simple. I've gone as far as I can go in the wrestling business, winning the DUI Women's Championship, so this is the next step in my goal to becoming a huge star in the industry. So when Doxzilla made me an offer, I couldn't refuse. I jumped on it. And Doc, you're so big, Doc. I've never been with a man as hung as the Doc is. Although the gambler comes close, I didn't think it would even fit. But Doc assured me it would, and he must be Houdini, as he was right. Thanks to his patience and some appendages from Doc's shop of appendages, he was sliding it all the way in and out of me in no time. And now, as an LI ring rat, I get to go to all the LI VIP parties at the Palace and hobnob with celebrities, or should I say, Bob the Knobs of celebrities. Fashion and class, while taking it up the ass, that's my new model. So you'll have to forgive me if I don't sit down. All that late night LI training with Doc and Kate, you know. But to set the record straight, I'm not leaving wrestling or Brutal Impact or even my dear sweet boyfriend, the one. No, it's just I'll be having plenty of other boyfriends and girlfriends now as well, thanks to my new job at Monkey House. Everyone is just so sweet and nice to me. Very nice people. So I hope my sweet darling one understands. I'm sure he will though when I get home tonight after getting hammered by my co-star the gambler and the other 30 men in the shoot. Maybe you can spray me down with the garden hose and then we can play that game you like to play. You know the one. Anyway, I gotta get going now. I got the fashion, I got the class, but now Doc is calling me and said to take it in the... Well, you know. Bye, everyone. Talk to you later.
Hello, world. Here's a song that we're singing. Come on, get happy.
Welcome back once again to UFI fans. It's 24/7. And oh, look at this coming down the ramp. It's none other than Charade with her new, why could it be? Gambler. And next to me is none other than the one, the only, the one. It's the one.
I'm kind of confused now, Doc. The gambler, he's kicked out of Brutal Impact. What the heck is that even? I'm confused now. What is Sheree? I'm confused.
Maybe you didn't get the memo, but it looks like, like I said, Sheree's got a little candy on her arm with the gambler, and it's nice to see the gambler back. Actually, he's looking a little bit better since he's up Brutal Impact. Got a little bit more, better attire, and a little bit more, you know, in the strut. And look at Sheree trying to show off some of the techniques she may have learned in her new... movie career as well.
Sheree doesn't have a new movie career. What the heck are you talking about? That's a bold-faced lie right there. Sheree does not have a movie career.
I don't know about that. It seems like she was applying something like that in the promo earlier. But I don't know, like I said, you know, maybe you didn't get the memo, maybe you've been busy, but who knows what's going on in the Brule Impact House. But Sheree definitely going to be in this match, which is a qualifier or for the tournament for the DUI title that she was stripped of, and her opponent is none other than Sheree.
Yes, this is a first-round tournament. I don't know exactly how many women are in this tournament right now. I know there are more than, obviously, Sheree and Sheree, but we'll just have to see as the tournament goes on how many more women are entered into this tournament. But Sheree trying to get some gold back into the cybernetic family.
I am Sheree.
Indeed, and agreed. No telling how many divas are going to be involved in this tournament that the Dark Wheel has laid out since she had you stripped of the title after you tried giving it to Sheree. But again, like I said, there's Sheree going in the first round here, so she does have a chance of getting it back. But like I said, Sheree represented the cybernetic family. It's going to be one long, grueling match.
I'm definitely sure it is. And what is that empty chair doing? Okay. Good thing Gambler's not coming over here, because otherwise I'd have to beat him down again.
Well, the bell has rung and the action has begun, and you know, since we have been getting a lot of ringside visitors lately, I figured it'd just be easier just to have the chair here, just in case. You never know who wants to join. So, oh my, look at that Sheree getting her face busted out the front of the booth. And speaking of which, that strain out her nose? She get a nose job?
Oh,
see that hook.
I don't know. I honestly do not know. This is not the charade I know, using those tactics and letting Sheree overpower her so easily right now. And that's not even normal charade clothing. What the heck is going on?
Well, maybe she's trying to distance herself from the Brutal Impact. And now that she's kind of going out on her own, getting a solo career, and also, you know, more publicity outside the wrestling ring herself with her new budding, you know, film career.
I'm still have no idea what you're talking about when it comes to a film career, because I know... Oh, crap.
Oh, and look at that. Sheree getting knocked out on the ring. Oh, and Sheree going right after her. You know what? When you're going for the title, you have to expect this. It's good to see the Gambler keeping to himself. Ooh, Sheree with the reversal.
Yeah, I'm still not sure why Gambler is even out here. He has no business out there, even if that is the real Sheree, which I honestly, right now, have some doubts that it's the real Sheree, but I can't put my finger on who it might be at this moment.
I'm sure it's a genuine trade. The fact that it's a real, I mean, after all, this is a tournament for the title. And they're a movie together, Sheree and the Gambler. So, I mean, obviously just for publicity tours, they have to travel together. And why not come out to the ring together and help, you know, boost the popularity? But right now, it looks like Sheree doesn't even care about the Gambler as she's laying it down on Sheree. You got to ask her, ref, get in there.
Oh, the ref was asking, but she got out of the hold, or Sheree let go of the hold right then. But why isn't a member of the cybernetic family with Sheree tonight? Where the heck are they? Gotta wonder about that.
Well, I think Sheree can hold her own. She's never been one that needs to help. Oh, look at this Sheree with the octopus.
Yeah, that's an octopus stretch, and very well applied right there, and another amateur wrestling move right here from Sheree. What the heck is going on?
Well, obviously she's been training with somebody that knows how to get their legs wrapped around pretty well, because she's definitely showing. Oh, look at this bridging. Oh, my.
Oh, my. That's like a variation of a surf-type move that they use primarily in Mexico. That was a very impressive move, and I know I taught Sheree some of these moves from my world travels, but I'm still not convinced this is the real Sheree for some reason. I just have my doubts. I can't help it.
And look at this, Sheree with the same programming from the Luchadors as her time spent down in AAA, able to counter, if you will, with some grappling moves, and there they go, back to brawling once again.
That is very true, and oh, nice fist drop right there, but I don't see how that would do a lot of damage when Sheree was just standing outside the ring on the ropes.
I don't know, but that taunting, like I always say, can't be taunting in the ring, and it cost Sheeran that time. But look at that charade. Oh, charade with taunting of her own. Oh, my.
Oh, nice spinning heel kick right there from Sheeran, and Sheeran's showing a lot of moves here tonight that she must have been learning while on a little hiatus from the DUI.
You know what? She may have been learning some of this from the gambler for the time he's been around. You know, he's learned a move or two.
I wouldn't say that since we kicked him out of Brutal Impact. He hasn't really been doing a whole lot from what sources have told us.
Well, he hasn't been doing much in the ring, but he's been following his career outside the ring in front of the camera. Getting involved in the film industry as much as Shreya is, unload that huge drop kick, once again sending Sheeran to the outside.
Ooh, nice fist drop right there, but again, not doing a lot of damage. I don't know why she is so fixed on doing those fist drops, as there's a very nice arm drag.
Very nice indeed, as they said, and look at these two just going after it. Like you said, this is for the women's DUI title. It's the tournament, like elimination rounds, if you will. The winner of this match will definitely move on and get one step closer to that title, which you had been last held, but unfortunately you tried giving it to Charade, which the Dark Wheel then, you know, vacated it. And once again, now we have Charade going for the title.
Well, I was just trying to do the right thing. I mean, I'm not going to go fight women, and plus I want to be the DUI World Champion again. Oh, Gambler trying to put his hands on Sheeran, and that's not a smart move, Gambler. You could get DQ'd for that, and then Sheree would be out of the tournament.
And not to mention, he might get his ass kicked from Sheeran.
Oh, that is very true. Sheeran is very tough. She's one of the original women in the DUI, and she's proven time and time again just how tough she can be.
Yeah, that's just a Siron with add-ons, if you ask me. So, yeah, I'd be careful. You know, never know which programming she's going to switch to.
Oh, that was a very nice wheelbarrow facebuster and a nice dodge of that kick, but Charade still just the one move ahead of Sheeran at this moment.
And that's what she's going to have to do, is stay one move ahead so she can advance in this tournament and get the title that was bestowed upon her, but rightfully stripped of. And oh, look at this. Looks like she's tuning up the band.
What? this is not a charade move. This is apparently called the illusion, but that's not the illusion I know. What the heck is going on?
It was the illusion, but I don't know if she got full effect on it. As Sheeran sees it, and look at this, she's going old school once again. Oh,
this moveset like looks very moves. Familiar now that I'm seeing more of it, with again an illusion right there. But this moveset is not really the moveset I've known Sheree to use before. I'm starting to get an idea.
But you know what? That move says all she needed to get the job done, as Charade gets the win tonight and advances in the tournament one step closer to the women's DUI title. And look at that, the gambler in there giving his co-star the hand raising and the bestowing the gratitudes of her win.
Ah, jeez, we don't really need to see him in there, do we? Can someone please get him out of there? Come on now. Get the gambler out.
He can go anywhere he wants, I suppose. I mean, he's not violating anything. And like you said, you know, it's great to see that Charade is, you know, advances that charade. Oh, look at that once again. Showing that the Ghostars, they do have a film coming out pretty soon. So, you know, it's good to see them together and the camaraderie of the DUI
together. Not in my mind.
Okay, well, relax, man. You know, it's just for publicity, you know, stuff. It's not like I don't think they're foul.
I don't think that at all. I know better than that, but this is just wrong. Something is going on here, and I'm going to get to the bottom of it, because that move Charade usually does not use at all, and it looks like another move here in the DUI.
Well, either way, she's advancing in the tournament, like I said, one step closer to the DUI title. It looks like the gambler and Charade are quite celebratory after her win tonight, and I don't blame her. Getting the gold around your waist is what it's all about. And, oh, look at that. Looks like they're actually a little bit closer. Oh, there it is.
I'm going to be
that's the what? Oh, wait, what's the down set? Uh-oh, too late. The one head to the ring. Oh, my, look at this. He couldn't take the one. Oh, the one beat a bully. Look at that, taking it out on the gambler. I guess that's all he could see. He couldn't handle it no more. The blood boy, oh, look at this. Chewing out Charade. And Charade begging for it. Wanted to leave Gambler alone. Doesn't want any more harm to it. A little one frustrated. Even playing his music. What a bully. Oh, my.